Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover reverb. This is an effect that allows instruments that are recorded dry to sound as if they're playing in a large room and really gives a sense of space to your mix. Reverb can make a huge improvement to a track if used properly, but can also cause a lot of issues if used incorrectly. So we're going to start off with some of the different controls that are common to a lot of reverb processors. We'll go over how this affects our perception of room size and some tips on how to change the characteristics of the room. Then we'll check out a few of our presets we like to use on our recordings. One of the controls reverb effects often has is the size of the room. By adjusting factors such as delay time, the reverb effect can simulate anything from a small bedroom to a large concert hall. We'll start off with a small room size and increase it as the track is playing. When sound reflects off the walls of a room, it doesn't immediately disappear. Instead, it can bounce back and forth off the walls, weakening each time it does that. The decay option controls how long the sound reverberates in the room and is a major factor in how obvious the reverb effect will be. Be careful when adjusting this control. Low decay settings will produce a barely noticeable delay, but increasing it too far will cause the reverb to start to blend together and can easily make a huge mess of your mix. Another control is the level of the early reflections. This is the sound that occurs after the original signal but before the full reverberation. It is basically just the first reflections off the wall that reach your ear. You'll want to keep this control fairly low, as in below 50%, but make sure you do use it since it contributes to our perceptions of room size. Like some of our other effects we've covered, the reverb effect can also have a control for width. This determines how wide the sound will be in stereo, and you'll want to adjust it accordingly to maximize the stereo width of your track while trying not to clutter your mix. The next two controls are high and low frequency cut. They are basically like an EQ for your reverb, however they only affect the wet reverb and not the dry signal. With these controls, you can cut out high or low frequencies as if the walls of the room are absorbing them. The damping control affects how much the sound appears to be absorbed by the walls of the room as it reverberates. The best way I can describe it is to compare a room full of furniture with an empty room. In the empty room, you'll hear a lot of scattered reflections and echoes as the sound continues to bounce off the walls. In the furnished room, the sound still reverberates, but a lot of it is absorbed by furniture and it doesn't sound as reflective. Turning the damping down would be like an empty room, while high damping would be like a furnished room. Diffusion is another control that sounds like it affects the length of the reverb. At low settings, the reverberation continues longer and the track is left with long reverb tails. As the diffusion is turned up, the reverberation does not last as long and becomes tighter with the original signal. Like some of the other controls, diffusion can also change how we perceive the room to be. At a long diffusion setting, the long reverberation time makes it sound like it's being played in a large auditorium. As the diffusion gets larger, the room size appears much smaller. At this point, we're going to go over a few examples of some reverb presets included with our digital audio workstation. The first preset we like to use is called Great Hall and makes the track sound as if it were playing in a large room. The settings for this effect have a large room size and width, which is what we would expect from a large room. It also has a high frequencies cut down, so there's not too much high-end reflection going on. The damping is set to 100% to prevent too much fluttery reflection sounds, and the diffusion has a medium setting of 70%, which gives a reasonable amount of reverberation without getting cluttered. Another preset we'll go over is the guitar amp verb. This is a very quick sounding reverb, but it's still very noticeable. It gives the impression of a small but very reflective room. The settings have a small room size and decay, large width, and minimal high frequency cut with a large low frequency cut. Damping and diffusion are both set to zero, giving a long and very reflective reverb sound. One final recommendation we have when using reverb is to limit the difference between the different settings. For example, if you're using different settings for guitar, drums, and vocals, the three different reverbs can quickly start to clash, leaving your mix in a confusing mess. One option you can consider is to pass all the tracks you want through the same reverb processor. Specifics to how this is done will depend on your digital audio workstation. This will process all the tracks together and leave you with a much cleaner reverb. Thanks for watching this video on how to use reverb effects. If you learned something from this video, don't forget to give us a like and subscribe to the channel. If you're looking for more videos to watch, you can check out our videos on getting started with Audacity. To keep up to date on all our new videos, you can like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Links to our social media accounts can be found in the video description.